baby, you move like the ocean. Hey, I'm loving the motion, tick, tick, tick. Oh my God, I gotta dive right in. Morning.
Hello, human beings.
Hey, guys.
What is up? It is
Beauty
and the Freak. And today, as you can see from the title, we're doing the Kendrick Lamar verse, just his verse.
Yeah, like, try and look cool.
Anyway, control verse, just Kendrick's verse because of all the controversy going on with Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, Drake. We got Future in the equation now, as you guys know. And we're going to be doing a separate conversation on those particular topics. And we're also going to be doing a reaction to the J. Cole verse on the Future album, which is like, what, Red Leather. But, yeah. So we're just going to do Kendrick's verse on this, just to show her this verse, because it's really cool. And I want to see her reaction. It's a great verse. If you're new to the channel,
please like and subscribe.
And comment down below. And check your boys' music out. The intro song, that was me, all right? I also have a song called Stay Up that we also have a merch line to, all right? It says Stay Up, okay?
Beauty.
She's got Beauty merch as well, so y'all check her merch out, all right? Just check out the link, all right? We got other stuff, too, on there. It's really cool. This is called Bad Fish Brand. Just saying.
I'm pretty sure they
know. No, they don't. There's new people who come to this channel all the time.
Gotcha.
If you do know, then you do know. But if you don't know,
now you know.
All right. So if you're new to the channel, you probably don't know that we do one round of rock, paper, scissors now, and then two rounds at the end. Stick around to see who wins.
Okay, ready?
I was not trying to rhyme there. All right, let's get it.
Yep.
So remember, you got to pay attention. We got the lyrics pulled up for her. But it's going to be on some rappity rap stuff. This is him pretty much saying he is the king of rap right now. Current king of the rappers.
I feel like this would have been better with one of your boys. Like, no, your reaction would have been like...
No, it's better with you because you're the one who don't listen to rap.
I know. I feel like there will be more dialogue going on.
It doesn't matter. This is the fun part of it. We have a lot of videos where she interacts to like Eminem, rap, right. Just rappity rap stuff. Her facial expressions are really funny. I do some breakdowns. I don't do it like a lot, but if I catch a bar, I'll discuss it. But half the time it's something I've already heard,
right?
And I'm getting her to react to because it's funny. So here we go.
Miscellaneous minds, left explaining the minds. Devilish grin for my alias, aliens in the spine. Peddling sin, thinking maybe weird, you can hold your eyes. I'm not gonna fold in the mass. I don't smoke crack, motherfucker, I sell it. Bitch, everything I rap is a quarter piece to your melon. So if you have a relapse, just relax and pop in my disc. Don't you pop me a fucking pill, I'ma pop you, then give you this.
How's it sound so far? Really lyrical, right? Kind of hard to keep up with,
yeah,
right?
The only part I heard was, I don't sell weed.
I don't smoke crack, motherfucker. Right. I sell it. That's what he said. But yeah, he's saying he sells, you know, that fire musically.
Oh.
You know?
Okay. You get see, people addicted. That, the interpretation just went over my
That's
head.
That's what I'm here for, baby. All right. So now he about to get real crazy into the beat. Let's go back.
It's a great piece to your medicine. So if you have a relapse, just relax and pop in my disc. Don't you pop me no fucking pill, I'ma pop you, then give you this. Tail flex and drop a bomb on this shit. So many bombs with the alarm like Vietnam on this shit. So many bombs with Farrakhan, think that's a dime in this bitch. One at a time, I line them up and bomb with the mom. She watching the kids, I'm in a destruction mode. If the gold exists, I'm important like the Pope. I'm a Muslim on pork, I'm aggravated sauce break. I'm the king of New York, king of the coast. One hand, I juggle them both, and juggernaut.
Love that part.
King of New York.
I'm the Muslim on pork because they don't eat meat. Mm. You know, apparently, so that's a wild Muslim. Mm. But I'm the king of the West and the East Coast. I juggle them both on one hand. He's from the West Coast, mm. You know, California. but he's flexing, basically.
Yeah, I can see that. Or hear that, anyway.
Oh, yeah. He letting everybody know he the best. There's one part
you gotta... Is he? I don't know. I'm asking you.
When it comes to the new school, he is.
Oh.
In my opinion. I've been a kid. Before all this beef, y'all can go back and look at the past videos. I've always said Kendrick may not be the most commercially successful. Because, you know, the big three. Drake, probably the most commercially successful one.
Right.
And then him and Kendrick, kind of neck and neck, I guess. I think Kendrick got a little bit more success than Cole. But maybe not recently. I really don't know. But when it comes to these lyrics, when it comes to this...
I like J. Cole. Or yeah. At least from what I've heard.
Well, it ain't about what you like. I'm just saying, like, when it comes to, like, who's the better rapper? Like, the best rapper, lyrically, that I'm going to go with this person if I'm choosing them in a rap battle.
But I'm thinking of, there's a particular song that he did with someone else. And he did really good lyrically, in my opinion.
Well, no, you're right. Like, that's why they're considered... the big three. Mm-hmm. So if you're on any of their sides, it's applicable.
Mm-hmm.
But honestly, like, let's be real about this shit.
I don't even want to remember the name of that song.
He's been on a couple features in the last year, but that's not the point here. Because they all can rap their ass off. Drake is really good at rapping. Cole is one of the best. Like, he was the one that I was rooting for until he apologized recently. But
you weren't expecting him to apologize?
I was saying that J. Cole is the one that's more, like, capable of beating Kendrick in a battle.
Gotcha.
If anybody beats him. Other than, like, some older veterans, like Eminem or, you know what I'm saying, Tech N9ne or something. But Kendrick got him off, messed up, to be honest. Like, you hear something like this, and this was, like, 7-8 years ago. Almost 10. I think it was 10 years ago, actually. Yeah.
Wait, this song?
10 years ago.
Dang.
Yeah. He was already eating motherfuckers up. But, Drake, it was Drake or J. Cole that was about to try to take this man down. But unless we hear something from Drake, unless Cole comes and redeems himself from this apology shit, Kendrick got him.
I guess roasts, you know, or beefs or whatever you want.
They're like roasts. It's like your homies sitting around just making fun of each other, but you're doing it in a rap battle.
Right. So this took 10 years. Like, do rappers, like, wait that long to, like, get back? No.
You got it mixed up. We've already reacted to Like That a couple weeks ago. That's what started the recent feud.
Oh.
This is just something I'm showing you because this is just some random stuff that, like, he literally name drops all these rappers.
Yeah, but you sounded like, the way you were talking made me feel like this was, like, a diss or something.
It's not a recent thing, no.
Gotcha.
I'm just bringing this thing back because he called this shit, like, 10 years ago when, like, hey, I'm the king of this shit.
Then never mind.
You'll see what I'm talking about when he starts name dropping.
Okay.
Watch.
I'm in public like the Pope, I'm a Muslim on coke, I'm aggravated, offspring, I'm the king of New York, king of the coast, one hand I juggle them both, the juggernauts all in your juggler, you take me for jokes, live in the basement, church pews and funeral faces, cardio bracelets, for my women friends I'm in Vegas, who the fuck y'all thought it's supposed to be, if Phil Jackson came back, still no coaching me, I'm uncoachable, I'm unsociable, fuck y'all clubs, fuck y'all bitches, your Instagram can gobble these nuts, gobble a dick up to your ink up, my big homie corrupt. This the same flow that put the rap game on a crutch. West. I see niggas transform like villain Decepticons. Molly's probably turn these niggas to fucking Lindsay Lohan. A bunch of rich ass white girls looking for parties, playing with Barbies. Wreck the Porsche before you give them the car key. Judgment to the monarchy. Blessings to Paul McCartney. You call me a black beetle. I'm either dead or a Marty. I don't smoke crack, motherfucker. I said I'm dressed in all black. This is not for the fan of Velvet.
I'm dressed in all black. This is not for the fan of Elvis. I like that.
For the what?
For the fan of Elvis.
Oh.
As in your typical Elvis fans, probably not going to like shit like this.
No.
We actually do reacting to Elvis every now and then.
Right.
Get it out.
It's hiccups.
Oh, hiccups? Yeah. Oh, I thought it was a burp.
So it's going to take a while.
Yeah. But yeah, I love this verse so much. But it's about to get better.
I'm aiming straight for your pelvis. You can't stomach me. You plan on stumping me. Bitch, I've been jumping for you. Put a gun on me. Bitch, I put one on yours. I'm Sean Connery. James Bond and with none of you niggas climbing 100 mil in front of me. I'm gon' get it even if you're in the way. And if you're in it, better run for Pete's sake. I heard the barbershops being great debates all the time about who's the best MC. Kendrick, Sugar, and Nas. Eminem, Andre 3000, the rest of y'all. New niggas, just new niggas. Don't get involved. And I ain't rocking no...
I love that line right there.
What line?
So where he's talking about, I heard the barbershops be, you know, be in great debates all the time. Like, who's the best MC? Kendrick, Jigga, which is Jay-Z, Nas, Eminem, Andre 3000. And honestly, that top five right there is just beautiful, honestly. Like, I would keep Kendrick in there. And this is greatest of all time, not just the new age, right?
Right, right.
Kendrick will be mine in there. Eminem, no particular order, by the way. Kendrick,
right.
Eminem, Andre 3000 for sure. I would probably replace the Jay-Z with me. I do rap though, all right? I would replace the Jay-Z with Tupac, and I would probably leave the Nas alone or put... this is just a personal opinion. Maybe like Ludacris in there. I like Ludacris, man. He doesn't get enough credit. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so he's talking about who's the best MCs. Those five. He's obviously putting his name in there. And now he's about to keep name dropping. This is pissing me off. Try holding your breath for 10 seconds.
Okay. Was that 10 seconds?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm like, dang, you should be counting.
I thought you was counting in your head.
No.
No. All right, let's get it. Hopefully they're gone.
Yeah.
No more designer shit. White tees and Nike Cortez. This red Corvette's synonymous.
We usually homeboys with the same bitches I'm riding with.
But this is hip hop and them niggas should know what time it is.
I'm usually homeboys with the same bitches I'm rhyming with. He didn't say bitches, but I can't say that word.
Right.
You know that. Didn't want to go there.
Right. We don't want no problems.
Yeah, but listen to what he's saying now. I'm usually homeboys with the same people I'm rhyming with. So it kind of like shows, like, now, like, even J. Cole, why'd you apologize? Even if he's your homeboy, you can still want to smoke with him.
Right.
You can still go at his ass.
Yeah.
Maybe keep it a little friendly, but just say, hey, I'm the best rapper, not you. So it was a weird move on J. Cole's part.
And there goes for Jermaine Cole, Big Crit, Wale, Pusha T, Meek Mills, A$AP Rocky, Drake, Big Sean.
Who's Pusha T?
So you missed it. Jermaine Cole is J. Cole.
No, I got that.
Oh, I didn't know you knew.
Who's Pusha P?
Pusha T.
I think that's...
Oh, it's the guy who, he's a good rapper. He and Drake actually had a rap battle few years ago, and he actually did really good. He actually kind of killed him.
Yeah.
Told him to be a daddy.
Now listen. Nike Cortez, this red Corvette, synonymous. I'm usually homeboys with the same niggas I'm rhyming with, but this is hip hop, and them niggas should know what time it is.
J. Cole, first one.
J. Cole, for Jermaine Cole, Big Crit, Wale, Pusha T, Meek Mills, A$AP Rocky, Drake, Big Sean, J. Electron, Tyler McMillan. I got love for you all, but I'm trying to murder you niggas. Trying to make sure your core fans never heard of you niggas. They don't want to hear not one more noun or verb from you niggas. What is competition? I'm trying to raise the bar high. Who's trying to jump?
So this part right here is a very descriptive storytelling moment. And he could have said this so fucking basic, but he literally was like, all right, I'm going to give you every single detail like it was in a little movie, right? Okay. So what is competition? I'm trying to raise the bar high. Who trying to jump and get it? You better off trying to skydive out of the exit window with 5 G5s with 5 grand with your granddad and the pilot drunk as fuck trying to land, right? But watch, wait. Listen
just
to what he's saying.
Just seeing your, like, you know.
Passion.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I love rap. Because
don't look at me, guys. Look at him.
But I rap myself, and I rap very technical when I do rap. I usually sing my hooks, but I rap my verses usually. And she knows. I got real fast verses. I got not fast verses. I love the art of hip hop. Is just what I love, and the way he breaks this shit down and ends it is crazy.
fans never heard of you niggas. They don't wanna hear not one more now, no verb from you niggas. What is competition? I'm trying to raise the bar high. Who's trying to jump
again?
You're a better off trying to skydive out the exit window with 5G5s with 5 grand with your granddad as the pilot. He's drunk as fuck trying to land with a handful of Arthur riders and popping prosthetic leg, bumping pop in the cockpit. So the shit that pops in his head is an option of violence. Someone heard the story that said that your parachute is a latex condom hooked to a thread.
Someone told the stewardess that your parachute was a latex condom hooked to a dread. So you had no chance of surviving that skydive, okay? She's hard to keep up sometimes when it comes to this stuff, but like this is literally aggressive poetry. This is what I've always called rap music. You got rap music that isn't aggressive poetry. It's just right. It's just poetry. Like I have songs that are just something I would show up to an open mic with, right? I have a song called Homeless, all right, for you guys that are new to my stuff. But when it's more aggressive, it's still poetry.
Right.
You know, you're rhyming, you're making somebody think, you're painting a picture. It's beautiful.
That was one of our first dates. He spoke at a poetry
venue. At a coffee shop. Really nice. It was an open mic. Yeah. That was cool. That was fun.
Yeah.
I used to do that like every Sunday.
And then he also did one in like downtown in that big
in
building.
The poetry club.
Yeah. It was really awesome because he did it with like high school students mm-hmm. and stuff.
They had me as a special guest.
Yeah, they were, like really personally cool, requested you.
Yeah, that's fire. Cool. Good times. So yeah, check my catalog out. That's not a shameless plug, by the way. All right. If you're new to the channel,
please like and subscribe.
And comment down below. And check the merch out, right? So when you guys support our merch, you also donate to a charity, okay? No Kids Hungry Foundation, all right? So even when you buy our merch just to rock it for positivity, you're also doing something good for humanity, all right? We don't have a lot of this out there.
No, we take it very seriously because we try to give back as much as
That's
we can.
Right. That is right.
Who won the... I did. Yeah, I did. Okay.
I think I did.
No, I did. Ready?
1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, I win. Usually when I say I win, I do. But dang it, you got me. All right, guys. Well, y'all have a blessed day. Be productive. Do something positive. Give somebody a hug who may need it. Stay up.
Stay awesome, guys.
Baby, you move like the ocean. I'm loving the motion, tick, tick, tick.